Prime Minister Narendra Modi honors Chalna for excellent implementation of Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. In Maharashtra, BJP wins Latur and Chandrapur Municipal Corporation, Congress wins Parbhani. Thank you, Rikma. Good evening and welcome to MetroScan from Mumbai. And now let's the news in detail. Prime Minister Narendra Modi today honored Jalna collector Shivaji Jondre for his excellent performance in the implementation of the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana in Jalna during the Kharif season of 2015-16. Total premium of 25 crore were paid and 95% farmers under the insurance scheme received 431 crore as compensation. This year during Rabi season, total premium of 2 crore was paid and around 44 crore was received as compensation by farmers. In another achievement, state government's initiative of Magel Tyala Shetre Farm Ponds on Demand got selected in top 10 innovative schemes in India. Prime Minister Narendra Modi today distributed Prime Minister's Award for Excellence in Public Administration on the occasion of 11th Civil Services Day today in capital. And continuing with its winning streak, Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis-led Bharatiya Janata Party managed to wrest power in the Congress-dominated Latur civic body and retain its power in Chandrapur Municipal Corporation, whereas Congress pressed Parbhani. In a major victory, Bharatiya Janata Party would have won 38 seats out of 70 seats of Latur Municipal Corporation, pushing Congress Party to second position. Congress, that had won 49 seats in 2012 polls, could retain 28 seats in the Latur. Talking about the victory, BJP MP from Latur, Sunil Gaikwad, said this result shows that people has exude confidence on BJP government. In Chandrapur Municipal Corporation, BJP won 38 of 66 seats. The Congress is distant second, winning by 12 seats. Whereas in Parbhani Municipal Corporation, Congress won 29 seats out of 65. NCP came at the second position, winning 28 seats, while the BJP won 8 seats and Shiv Sena got 6 seats. And BJP Chief Amit Shah today inaugurated the 29th Savarkar Sahitya Sammelan today in Thane. This is for the first time the city of Thane witnessed the 29th edition of Savarkar Sahitya Sammelan. Savarkar Darshan Pratishthan spokesperson Ravindra Sate informed that the three-day meet will comprise a symposium, panel discussion, exhibition, plays related to the teachings of Swatantra Veer Savarkar. Sate also informed that the issue of national interests like defense, preparedness, national security, social reforms and various topics related to the legendary freedom fighter Veer Savarkar will be discussed in the conference. Earlier, Thane BJP unit also held a public rally in the presence of Amit Shah. And with an alarming rise in the number of reported cases of swine flu in Maharashtra's Nashik, Pune, Ahmednagar and Nagpur, Health Department has issued an advisory asking people not to ignore symptoms of H1N1 virus. In Nagpur so far, 12 are reported dead and 49 people are diagnosed with H1N1 virus. Medicines are also made available in 19 licensed medical shops in Nagpur.
People should avoid going to a very crowded places and they should keep themselves away from those patients having this type of symptoms like cough and some sort of difficulty in breathing. Try to be away from those patients. And if they notice such type of symptoms, they should report to a clinician or a nearest hospital as early as possible so that the progression, we can arrest it at that level only, early stage.
Climate change is gradually becoming a central topic of debate and strategies decision-making for governments, multilateral organizations and business all over the world. On this occasion, background conference on industries with support of Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations had organized a conference on sustainable and climate smart agriculture in Mumbai. Dignitaries who were present at the conference deliberated upon the policy intervention, conceptual framework and awareness of CSA, developing sustainable and inclusive agriculture and food value chain.
Can predict some of these things from happening. Now that's a big challenge, because what climate change is doing to us is that the past is no longer a predictor of the future. What is going to happen in the future is something that we still don't really know. The models are still being developed, and although there are models that can predict what's going to happen 20 years, 30 years, 50 years, what can happen tomorrow or day after is less predictable. But there is technology there. So if you find, for example, personally,
Minister Embassy of Republic of China Liu Jinsong today said that India and China are forerunner of economic globalization in the world and both countries should work to revive the Silk Route. He was speaking at the Belt and Road Initiative, India's perspective on China's ambitious plan for infrastructural connectivity in Asia, Africa and Europe conference in Mumbai. He added that Belt and Road Initiative is not just about one belt, one road, but it is a systematic network of regional cooperation. He stressed that China has no intention to interfere in the territorial and sovereignty disputes between India with its neighbor through China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. Jinsong stated that China has proposal to build China-India and Nepal business corridor to smoothen trade. And according to census of 2011, 2.6 crore people in India are disabled. Supported by Google, organization Ratna Nidhi Trust conducts mobility camps across the country and provides free prosthetic legs, thereby helping the needy. Let's take a look.
Five-year Abdul Khan was born with disability, but this story changed after he started walking with the help of Jaipur Foot. Mumbai-based Ratna Nidhi Charitable Trust helped in changing Abdul's life by taking up a noble cause to provide mobility to people with disabilities get back on their own feet.
हमारे पास एक लड़का आया था अब्दुल का नाम था पांच साल का था जन्म से उसके पास दो पांव नहीं थे रोज माँ को बोलता था कि मुझे फुल पैंट पहनना है और शूज पहनना है माँ रोती थी क्योंकि पांव ही नहीं है तो फुल पैंट पहनने का सवाल ही नहीं है और शूज नहीं है वो हमारे पास आया वो दिन हमने उसके दोनों पांव बनाए वो हंसते हंसते घर पे गया एक महीने के बाद वापिस आया फुल पैंट जीन पहना था टेनिस शूज पहना था आपको मालूम ही नहीं सके कि ये दो लड़के का दो पांव नहीं है आज वो उनकी आंख में खुमारी है वो स्कूल में वो प्रेम से बैठता है सब लोगों के साथ
डोंडू जी लॉस्ट हिज बोथ लेग्स इन ट्रेन एक्सीडेंट आफ्टर व्हिच ही वाज कंप्लीटली ब्रोकन लाइफ चेंज्ड एज ही कुडंट गो फॉर वर्क नॉर वाज एबल टू वॉक बट टुडे विद हेल्प ऑफ कस्टमाइज्ड जयपुर फुट ही इज एबल टू डू एवरीथिंग विद ईज
सर ये जो आर्टिफिशियल पैर लगाने के बाद कैसे आपकी जिंदगी में आप जैसे रोजमर्रा की चीजें पहले करते थे वैसे ही किया करते थे
किया
और किस इस हादसे को कैसे आपने दुनिया के लिए एक मिसाल कायम की है
कोई का बहुत लोग को मैं देखता है तो लोग ही बताता है कि तुम आयशक के ऊपर कैचे के ऊपर चलता है तो फिर पाव लगा के जाओ ना तुमको भी अच्छा लगेगा चलने का भी हैप्पी लगेगा किसको पता नहीं लगेगा वो हैंडीकैप है करके तो लोग कोई समझते कोई कोई आदत लगी ले वो क्रैचेस में चलने का तो वो क्रैचेस में चलते हैं चलने के लिए वो कुछ तकलीफ नहीं होती है बहुत अच्छा बैठने के लिए अच्छा होता है अपने को बाथरूम में जाने के लिए अच्छा होता है वो खड़ा भी रह सकता है और काम भी कर सकता है आराम के साथ ऑफिस में फिर बस में जा सकते हैं ट्रेन में जा सकता है कैसे भी जा सकता है आदमी क्यों उसको मालूम ही नहीं पड़ता क्योंकि उसको हैबिट लग गया ना तो मालूम ही नहीं पड़ता आदमी को
कहा जा सकता है कि बहुत सारी लोगों की उम्मीदें यहाँ पर आके पूरी हो रही है उन्होंने अपने हादसे में पैर खो दिए हैं और पहले जैसे जिंदगी बिताने का एक बहुत ही बड़ा साहस मिला है और ऐसा साहस मिला है कि अपनी जिंदगी पहले जैसे ही बसर कर सके कैमरा पर्सन आदित्य कसारे के साथ ममता भट्ट डीडी न्यूज मुंबई
With innovation and technology coming up in the hospitality business, Mumbai has recently welcomed the Pod Hotel concept under the name of Urban Pod. Urban Pod is the next smart accommodation at a convenient cost with unique experience. Pod Hotels are a smart stay option for all kinds of travelers. More on this report.
The hospitality industry in India is developing at a fast pace, bringing in new age concept hotels, pioneering a new segment of smart hotels. The first of its kind pod hotel in India under the name of Urban Pod is launched in Mumbai. With its Gen Next and futuristic concept, Urban Pod indulges the discerning travelers with a smart stay option. Urban Pod is modern, stylish and minimalistic, perfect for anyone seeking luxury accommodation on a budget, with the price range starting from 2000 to 2500. It offers 140 pods with various upgrades. Suite pods, private pods, classic pods for men, and exclusive ladies-only pod category with added safety and privacy. The hotel has three communal bathrooms and a common dining area, and luggage can be deposited in lockers. The pod comes with hooks, a television on the ceiling, a USB port, a socket for earphones, AC vents, reading lights, a fire alarm, an extinguisher, and Wi-Fi facility. The architecture and design is the brainchild of leading architecture firm called Formvix in Singapore. Founders Shalabh Mittal and Hiren Gandhi came up with the idea after having an interesting pod hotel experience in Singapore.
अर्बन पॉड एक स्मार्ट होटल है जो हमारे हमारे जो पार्टनर है शलभ और बर्लिन वो लोग ने मुझे शेयर किया था ये आइडिया जो सिंगापुर और ईस्ट एशिया में काफ़ी पॉपुलर है सो हम लोग ने जाके खुद एक्सपीरियंस किया और हमने सोचा कि ये इंडिया में इंडियन ट्रैवलर्स के लिए एक अच्छा ऑप्शन बन सकता है सो वहाँ से हमको ये आइडिया आया और हम लोग ने इंडिया में मुंबई में पहला एक्सपेरिमेंट करने का ट्राई किया है सो हमें लगता है कि ये काफ़ी इंडियन ट्रैवलर के लिए काफ़ी किफ़ायती तरीके से एक ऑप्शन बन जाएगा एज अ होटल और स्टे ऑप्शन
दे सून रियलाइज दैट मुंबई विद इट्स क्रैम्प्ड स्पेसेस एंड कंजस्टेड स्ट्रीट्स नीडेड अ पॉड होटल ऑफ इट्स ओन वेयर बिजनेस ट्रैवलर्स कैन स्टे विदाउट शेलिंग आउट टू मच मनी Rohi Malik's report for TD News, Mumbai.
Absolutely a good treat for the frequent traveler here. And that's all we had in this original Metro Scan from Mumbai. But we'll be back on Monday evening with some latest update. Till then, goodbye. It's back to you, Rukmar.